If you can't afford to look human, you're going to the farm. It's as simple as that.
Do you have any idea how much it costs to have an entire family in glamour?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Crane must have taken a shard. The open arms.
Enjoy your stay.
Thanks, Bigby. And thanks for covering for me last time, too.
Bigby? How could you do this to me?
I guess I finally see you for who you are! Tell me who did it! Just tell me who did it! I know you know!
I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women?
But, you know...
Just take him, okay? Take Crane.
Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen.
Point bullets are a nasty business. The silver slug deformed and shredded on impact.
He'll be okay, though.
Hmm?
He'll be okay?
His internal organs are positively riddled. If I don't extract every single scrap of silver, he's liable to suffer some long-term toxicosis. Easy there. Try not to move. We can't keep meeting this way, old boy. I figured I'd be done before you were conscious, but there's little I can do for the pain.
My arm?
Yes, very ugly, but not life-threatening. I can't say the same for these bullets peppered throughout your vital organs.
Please, Bigby, don't move it. Doctor!
Look, I'm a bit engaged saving his life at the moment, but if the fractured extremity concerns him that much, he can set it himself. For heaven's sake. See now? That wasn't so difficult, was it? That'll do. You're probably better off. This way I won't have to reset it later. He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this. He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
I don't know about that.
Well, he should. There are limits to what even I can do.
It's not like I asked for this shit to happen.
Yes, but it's not like you actively discouraged it either. Excuse me, Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay, at least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands. And I need the space to work, so if you wouldn't mind...
Stick around, all right? I don't know if I trust this guy.
Oh, please, I could do this with my optic nerve severed. We'll be done in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
Colin, leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
'Cause I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin... You're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be? I'm here to take care of my friend.
Could you please not distract the doctor while he has my chest cut open?
Yes, that would be helpful. There. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to, having visits with me. And, well, this time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue. Miss White, he'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been an unusual couple of days.
I know, but please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him, please.
I will. He'll need rest, I assume?
Sleep, mostly. Just keep watch.
Snow has enough to deal with, Swinehart. I can take care of myself.
Clearly. Anyways, guard against, as they say. Miss White? Sheriff? Colin?
Swiney?
So, how do you, feel?
It's Bigby, Snow. He'll be okay. Hell, I've seen him take worse.
As good as can be expected, I think.
So, not well then.
I'm glad you're not dead. You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess. It kind of scared the hell out of me. I've never seen you like that. And when Swinehart arrived, you know him, he's never worried. And even he thought you were...
Snow, I'd never leave you.
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way.
Colin...
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something? And who should I be asking? Should I be worried about the Crooked Man taking over?
The Crooked Man, Bloody Mary, the Tweedles. This is bigger than what I thought it was.
Yeah. The Crooked Man came out of the shadows for a reason. For him to attack us so blatantly like that. He either feels invincible or desperate.
Well, if those are my two options, I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying, that's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house money.
So he called my bluff. It's not like I'm gonna let Bloody Mary just murder.
Yeah, thanks, Snow, for all that back there.
No problem.
Thanks? You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop? Or that the Crooked Man thinks he's got Snow under his thumb?
We're all mad about it, Colin. But it's not like we had a strong choice in the matter.
What else could Snow do? If she didn't hand him over, my ass would be down the witching well. Crane still would have been taken.
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
All I care about right now is... just what does the Crooked Man want out of this? I thought he was just a loan shark, but clearly he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with Faith and Lily?
You know, I couldn't really give a shit what they want out of this. They just made the wrong fucking enemy.
Remember what Swinehart said, okay? The Crooked Man declared war against us last night. At least that's what I thought when it happened. But now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken. We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean, the right way?
What do you think I mean?
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way. Bigby's the one on the front lines. You can't give him a leash. He doesn't work that way.
Look, I know things haven't gone great recently, but we're still doing our best.
That's not good enough. So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
Pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of...
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters to fight monsters.
Colin, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice...
We were under attack, Snow. What did you expect me to do?
There are degrees.
Degrees? I only ever do what's necessary.
Really? Do you believe him?
Yeah, I do.
Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile and shave and take a shower now and then. Hell, I'm practically the president of the Bigby Don't Be Such a Dick Club.
Relax, Colin. I can speak for myself, okay?
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay? It's just that now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect. And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the farm.
Oh, give me a fucking break. Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
It's been the rule for a reason, Colin.
Look, everyone just calm down, all right?
I'm perfectly calm.
I'm not. Tell me right now, what's it gonna be, Bigby?
Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it? Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks. Guess who's waiting in your office right now? Narissa.
Narissa?
That broad from the pudding and pie?
Yes. Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. And what do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised.
She knows something. She's helped me a little with the case. Maybe she has something else.
Maybe she does. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking calls. And I should probably change out of these clothes. Consider the discussion tabled, but not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work. Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you? I mean, she seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here, right?
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you. Don't worry about it.
Thanks, Bigby.
Thank you.
Sheriff.
Hi, Narissa. Have a seat.
Are you okay? You didn't look good last night. I wasn't sure you'd be, you know, around.
Let's just say I've been better.
Huffin' Puffs. Not many people smoke those. Thanks.
You can start talking.
There's not a lot that I can talk about. You know that.
So that spell Crane was trying to break. It's not just while you're at work, huh?
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the pudding and pie, I told you what I was looking for, and you found a way to tell me. You sent me to the open arms. Maybe that'll work again?
You can try. I just... Go ahead.
You're here because the crooked man just sent Crane to the bottom of my list of worries. And you have something you want to say about that, right?
These lips are sealed. If I could answer you just like that, I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
Sometimes, we have to find our way through life on our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark. I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now, they're gone. And I don't know what to do.
Are you saying you need a friend right now? You can trust me.
What I'm saying is friends matter. And I don't have any left. So I hope you're looking after yours. Are you? Look around you.
Who are you talking about? Are my friends in danger?
I'm sorry. I thought I could do this. I need you to know I want to help, but...
But your lips are sealed.
I'm sorry if I'm wasting your time. I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons. Faith wore one too.
Do you like it? Hmm? Do you?
It's not how it looks that concerns me. It's what it does. That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it? Just take the ribbon off?
No! These lips are sealed!
What?
You can't! Just stay back! You can't do that!
Slow down. It's all right. I'm not gonna do anything.
Please, don't.
Okay. I get it. So the ribbons, if you take them off...
came here.
That's probably snow.
Listen, Sheriff. Can you keep this conversation between us? I could be in a lot of trouble. I shouldn't be talking to you.
What are you worried about?
Just, please don't say anything.
Sorry, I just need to talk to the sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
1 minute.
I might have a new lead for you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now. They said they wanted to talk to you about something. I wonder if they've heard about Crane.
Thank you for listening, Sheriff. You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time.
Wait, you don't have to go. That was abrupt.
It's one way to send a message.
What did she tell you? I didn't mean to rush her out. Did you get anything from her? Okay then. Good work. So, about Beauty and Beast. Do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look? What could they know about the Crooked Man? Or do you think they just heard about last night?
Well, whatever it is, I'm sure they called for a reason. Suppose I better go check it out.
You know, Beauty came to me a while back. She was looking for financial assistance. I told her there was nothing I could do, and she said that meant she'd have to go somewhere else. Bigby, you don't think she meant that she was going to go to the Crooked Man, do you?
That would explain why they called.
We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what? I have other matters to attend to.
And you didn't want to tell me what you were into either.
Good reason. Look what happened.
So that's back on me now. I thought we agreed that was settled.
You said it was settled. That doesn't...
Oh. What do you want?
Well, you're just going around knocking on doors? Stirring the pot?
Snow sent me. Said you wanted to talk.
Not me.
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
You think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted to talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
Can I...
So have you, Bigby. Yet, with all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy in this. I've had to hear about it all night long from her.
Who is it? Who's there? Beast?
If you don't want to talk, can you just get Beauty for me?
I don't know. Is it safe to turn my back? It's your pal, Bigby.
Hi, Bigby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
I guess I really do have the smallest apartment in the Woodlands.
I can already tell you're going to make a problem out of this.
What's he doing here? We don't need to bring him into this.
Beast!
I just don't think we can trust him. Not after the way he went behind my back. And then you run and call him again?
Well, I trust him.
Of course you do. He was keeping secrets for you.
It was one little thing. Do you want to keep fighting about that? Or do you want to try to sort this
Talk
out?
Talk about living
All
in the past.
We can handle this on our own. You didn't have to bring him here.
We're out of money. And answers. That's why I called. We'll finish this later. But we need to
Bigby.
Fine. If you want to talk, we'll talk.
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah, you know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
Beast!
No, really, I want to know. What are you trying to say, huh?
Nothing. It's a nice place you got here.
Thanks, but that's really not why I called.
Is this something about that loan you took out? From the crooked man?
I didn't know what else to do, so...
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate things.
I called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us. That's all I ever do.
I'd like to help you, but I can't do anything if you don't tell me what's going on.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the crooked man? What if we talk and you don't get him? And all this comes back on us? We'd be risking a lot. We've seen what happens when you cross the crooked man.
I can protect you, but only if you tell me what I need to know. And that means details. No more stonewalling.
We aren't.
Then just tell me what's going on here.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that
up. We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn, and we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just lived like... Let me just,
A day at the beach?
Skiing a slope?
Hey, we're not done yet.
And we can't come to the phone right now, so leave a message at the beep and we'll get back to you as soon as... humanly possible.
Beep!
That fucking message. I'm gonna come down there and bash your heads in with that machine if I have to call again and hear that fucking message one more time. I've been doing this long enough to know that if you had the cash, you'd have paid by now. So consider yourselves out of warnings. It's time to start thinking about how else you can settle this.
What the hell did you get yourselves into?
The crooked man's gonna get his, one way or another.
All I care about is, how can I find the crooked man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before. So, when I needed money, that's where I went. I didn't know what to do.
Wait, who do you deal with?
Jersey. You know, the Jersey Devil.
Oh yeah, that slimy prick. I didn't realize he was back on this side of the river.
And those Tweedles were always going in and out. Probably dropping off a loan payment they squeezed out of some poor fable. But never the Crooked Man. Mainly it's just regular fables. I can see now that it was a mistake, but I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day. Was in a display case.
I guess he's hit hard times too. There's a lot of that going around. I can't imagine he has a lot of marketable skills.
Fucking Bloody Mary must go through there. She had Woody's axe last night, trying to chop my damn head off with it.
Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man will come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble. And... you know that butcher shop, the cut above? It's the place on Tubman Street, Same block as the baker and the candlestick maker. Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the crooked man. And I don't think it's meat in the packages. You gotta understand, I needed work.
You have to believe us. We didn't think it would get like this.
Listen to me very carefully. Did you ever deliver to the crooked man? Can you give me an address?
No. I delivered to places all over town, but never to the man himself. It never seems to be heading to the same place, but it always comes out of the butcher shop.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up, and it's still not enough. I don't want Beauty to have to work, especially not where she was.
It's Mary you deal with? Bloody Mary is there?
No, Johann is the one who hands over the packages, you know, day to day. But I've seen her around there. She gets under my skin, you know, and I try to avoid her. But I don't need to tell you what she's like.
You're damn right you don't. I don't need a rundown on her reputation.
If Mary works out of there, I need to look into it.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty, give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like this, scraping to get by.
None of us should. We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home.
You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
Bigby.
So, where are you going? If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from. You know that butcher shop, the cut above? The thing is, I don't think it's meat in the packages. You know that...
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's behind that place. The Lucky Pawn. That's where...
You know that butcher shop?
I want to know what the Crooked Man is hiding at that butcher shop.
You know, Bigby, once you show up there, word is gonna spread. There may be nothing left for you to see if you go to the Lucky Pawn after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
Wait. I don't know what you're planning to do when you find the Crooked Man, but is there any way you could help us out?
What do you mean?
Well, maybe you can make this all just go away.
We would really appreciate it. What do you say?
Can you help us out?
I don't go around fixing debts. Lucky for you, what I am gonna do might just fix it anyway.
Just keep us in mind, please.
I'm sure you'll do the right thing.
He's got a whole lot of customers, or he doesn't have any. Right. Not very appetizing. Frozen solid. Who'd want to eat this?
bet that's what Beast was talking about. That logo looks familiar. I've seen this before at Antique Greenleaf's.
Bigby Wolf?
Well, welcome, Sheriff. What can I get for you?
You interested in a particular cut?
Let's see. What do we have in stock?
Let's see what we got here. Flank steak on special.
New York strip.
I can have some wild boar in tomorrow if you like. Sirloin, ribs, roast.
Johann, I want to know exactly what's going on here.
We sell meat. Did you want to buy something? What you see is what you get. Just meat. You'll find anything else. We just, we do more wholesale and meat packing than walk-up service. I'd like to help you. Really, I would. But there's nothing here. Sheriff, I... Did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real sorry. Hold on. I just gotta go check on that. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Butcher?
I just have to go see. Shit. I got it covered back here, Sheriff. I'll be right out.
Relax, Johann. I just want to talk.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes. Come on, damn it.
I'm just doing my job, Johann. What the fuck are you doing?
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. They're gonna kill me. Oh, God, she is gonna fucking kill me.
He's gonna get me killed.
Huh?
How you doing?
Please, Bigby. Please don't.
Bigby? What happened to Sheriff?
Please don't kill me, Sheriff. I don't want to die. Please don't kill me. Please don't kill me.
Listen, just calm the fuck down, okay? I just want some answers.
Okay. I'm dead. Either way, they said to me, Johann, you could keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both. What would you do? It was a simple choice to make in the moment.
Just open the door, Johann, and it won't be your problem anymore.
I can't.
Why not? What's back there?
I don't know. Honest. I've never been back there. It's locked from the other side. Look, I just worked the front. That's all I'm supposed to do.
Well, who locked the fucking door?
I'm not part of their crew. I don't know who or what goes on back there.
Crew?
The Crooked Man's people. Jersey Devil, Dean Dumb, and that mental case Bloody Mary. You want to talk about the real Butcher? It's her, not me. This is her place. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me, took over my storage and delivery a long time ago. All cause of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one. Oh, I let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up. Shows what I get for being nice. I'm just a victim in this. I don't know what they do back there. I swear. And I don't want to know. I'm not allowed to know.
Well, we're about to see what's back there. And then we'll see if I believe you.
I knew this would happen. Didn't know when.
is this place?
I told you, Bigby. I don't know. They muscled me out. I swear, I don't know anything more. I haven't been back here when it was like this.
Warning lights.
It's business. It's all I've ever had.
Damn it. You can't act like you're forced into this and then turn around and help them. You'd still be here if you hadn't flipped that switch out there.
I had to. You come in here making trouble for me. But you only give a shit now because the crooked man stepped on your toes or something. Where were you when they took this place from me? It hasn't been easy for me. You think I want to live with this at my back? I needed help. I needed your help.
All right, Johan. Do me a favor. Just shut the fuck up and stay out of the way. Can you manage that? So this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours, other kinds of magic. Could be dangerous stuff.
Maybe just don't touch anything back here, please?
Didn't I tell you to sit down and shut up? What are they making here?
I'm just a butcher. You want to talk T-bones? That I can do. This stuff is out of my league.
There are a lot of nasty spells you can make with the right equipment. That symbol. It's on all the packages. What is it?
That's the Crooked Man's, brand. It's on everything that goes in and out of here.
So you do know something, huh? Is that a wheel or what?
Guess they never used that thing on wolves, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
It's from back in the homelands. A torture device. It came over here with the rest of our stories. Not that Mundys need any help coming up with that kind of thing. It makes people crooked. By breaking their bones and... Do I really need to explain this?
Or something. Shit. Is everybody on here? Do you know anything about this?
I don't know. A lot of fables out there need a lot of things.
These are raw materials for making magic. Auntie Greenleaf and any other rogue witches out there probably get their supplies here. Don't you see what's going on here? All these fables getting magic from him. Business is booming. He's got all he needs. The raw materials, and with all this gear, looks like they could make just about any kind of magic. A lot of it. It's pretty clear why.
Oh, yeah? Why?
These shackles. He's using slave labor. No wonder people are coming to him for magic. Doing it like this, it's bound to be cheaper than the 13th floor.
This is just horrible. Things that must have gone on here.
It's the pudding and pie girls with the ribbons. Whoever he's got in here in these chains. He's enslaving fables. My watch. People just don't know the real cost of getting something cheap.
You don't have to tell me.
That fucker, Crane, knew all about it.
Yeah, what about Crane? If this all... I mean, finding the crooked man is so fucking important. Why don't you ask your boss?
Snow.
No, Crane. He said he knows where everybody is. I don't know how, but he's got some way. That's right. It was that creepy magic mirror with the big green head and all. Why don't you just use that? Find the crooked man that way. Leave me alone. Yeah, With stuff like that mirror, I'm surprised that you ever need to leave the office.
None of your business, Butcher. Don't worry about it.
Okay. Well, if they got their hands on an important magical item, there's only one place they'd take it. The Lucky Pawn. They probably took Crane there, too.
The Lucky Pawn. If I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the Crooked Man.
Hey, hold on. Well, I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. But what about me? Huh? What the hell am I supposed to do now? I'm gonna have to spend the rest of my short life looking over my shoulder for Bloody Mary. They won't care that I held up my end.
Report to the business office. Tell Snow I sent you there, and we'll figure something out. Some kind of protection.
Thank you. Thank you, Sheriff.
Jersey, don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just gonna...
my fucking
Jack,
system.
What the fuck is going on?
But you...
I'm the guy to keep shitting over, and that's it, Woody. If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place, huh?
I didn't pawn it, asshole. It was stolen.
So get the fuck out of my sight. Hit the bricks. See you later.
Hey. What's going on here?
What the fucking hell?
Christ, and this fucking guy too?
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
How the fuck do I know?
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna... You piece of shit.
Back it up, Jersey. You're dealing with me now.
You got here fast. Still looking for whoever killed them hookers? Or are you done chasing your tail?
Where's my axe? Who'd you give it to?
You follow me here all the way from Battery fucking Park? That's it?
Back off, dog. I just want what's mine. My axe.
You talk big, but I don't think you got the stones to back it up. Still a little sore, are we? Why should Mary get all the fun? You ain't so tough. You know what? I'm just gonna handle you myself. You fucking mother! Motherfucker!
What the hell are you doing? This is my fucking fight.
Not now.
Dog, you got a lot of nerve.
Yeah.
Magic Mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
You don't know anything about anything, do you? What do you have? Nothing. That useless bitch Snow White in a broken fucking mirror.
Oh! The next thing you say better be something useful.
You can't find a crooked man. No one can. Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot. You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. They dumped all his shit here. Bloody Mary uses this place like a fucking dump.
Where's Crane's stuff? Where'd they put it?
In back. Just go on. Get Crane's shit and go. Not that it's gonna do you any good.
See anything?
Crane's coat.
No time for traveler's checks, huh? He won't be needing this anymore. The shard. It's the shard. Finally.
Hey, Sheriff. Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you can do to bring them back. And I don't know what they did, but I do know this. Oh, if they're dead, it's because the crooked man wanted them dead. That's all it takes. So you can roar smash the place up. Shit, you can wail on me all you want, but what good is it gonna do you? Because he ain't in your town. You're in his. And he sure as shit is ready for you.
Out of smoke? Gonna lie, I was having trouble deciding which one of you to hit with this thing. Jersey was wrong.
About what?
About those girls. There is something you can do about it. You can get the fucker who did it. Ain't that the plan?
Yeah. Damn right it is.
All right, go do it then.
Hey, Woody.
Yeah?
You gonna be all right?
Thank you.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White,
Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss
White. You will have to wait. Just one moment, please.
Look what I found.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
I'm not in the mood. And you've got a lot to answer for.
Oh, really?
Bufkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Finally, things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine. So what else did you find out?
I gotta say, this thing reaches a lot further than we thought. The Crooked Man has something on everybody. It wasn't just Beauty and the Loan. Beast was working for him. His goon, the Jersey Devil, is putting the squeeze on all kinds of Fables down at the Lucky Pawn. And he's got Fables enslaved at the butcher shop, making black market magic.
This is worse than we could have imagined.
But that's over now, because we got the mirror. And once it's fixed, we got him. That's how Crane did it. That's how we're gonna do it.
Excellent work. Really.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Unbelievable.
Why the hell did you burn Crane's stuff, huh? And don't bullshit me. Bufkin was there. I know it was you.
Given Ichabod's obsession with Miss White, I thought it best to make sure that nothing untoward saw the light of day.
Oh, fuck off. I know you were burning evidence.
Then tell me, what evidence did I burn?
I have more important things to deal with right now. You can be sure that we're gonna have a long fucking talk about this when I'm done.
I do so enjoy our talks. I'll wait with bated breath.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Did he murder the
Got me.
Not necessarily.
Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know. So this process can be a little touchy.
Crane was carrying it for part of the night, at least. I found it in his coat. It's pretty amazing it's still intact after the fight, the kidnapping, and then riding around with Bloody Mary for however.
Yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help.
We've got enough problems.
It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
If you ask me, you're everything that's wrong with Fabletown.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Bufkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
Whitman, I take it. If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
You need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him. He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So, just break the news and be done with it, okay?
No budge on that bloody glamour. I only came in to see you,
but... Toad, come here.
I thought I made myself very clear.
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh? Why am I not surprised? Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallop because of you.
Before we get into any of that, what do you know about the Crooked Man?
Don't try to change a subject on me. I need a little bit of that walking around money, you know? My car, total, the gaping mole in my wall. Any of us sound familiar? I'm not looking for a handout. Just what's right. I need it, Big B.
Here, Crane won't be getting any use out of this. Will that do?
Crane's money, eh? Well, I suppose that means it belongs to me as much as anybody. Thank you, Sheriff.
Use it to get glamoured, Toad. You got the money now, so I won't be so lenient if I catch you again. And the farm is always on the table.
Good.
But of course.
You have to understand.
Bluebeard, you want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason. You know that as well as anyone.
Don't worry, I did the right thing.
Are you sure? Because he left looking pretty happy. Fine, we'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened to Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand or if it was one of his goons, but someone did. What would make a person do that?
I don't know, but when I catch the fucker who did this, I'll find out why.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
I have to say I have been better, but thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry, I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
He's probably still waking up a little.
Are you really sure you want to see him?
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
Just happened.
We pointed you in the wrong direction and looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Are you having trouble with the rhyme, Sheriff?
Poetry isn't part of my job description.
I haven't been feeling well of late. Seems neither of us can cooperate.
Damn.
Perhaps I can be of assistance? Mirror, mirror, keep us sane. Show the door to Crooked Man's domain.
I can always count on you, Buffkin.
I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold on.
The door. It moves.
Yeah, Jersey mentioned that.
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. We can't just dispense street justice. I know that emotions can run high, and you have your reasons to handle this a certain way.
I can't make that promise. This could turn sour, just depending on how the wind blows. I have to be able to handle it how I see fit.
If people are going to have faith in the Fabletown government again, we need to be fair. Show them that we're doing things the right way. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice. That's it, all right.
Good evening, Sheriff. I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way, for leaving off Tiny Tim. I have to admit, when they asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal. I know you aren't here on a social call.
You know, I kind of thought the Crooked Man would have bigger guards. Trolls, ogres. I'm almost insulted he doesn't.
Maybe he just wants to talk. I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do. Please don't make this hard on me.
Fine, lead on.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up. I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard, or an escort for that matter. I was a little surprised myself when they asked me to do it.
I get it. You have a job to do. But you gotta ask yourself if you want to be involved with this guy.
Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job. And I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got. Just keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fabletown is gonna get caught in the middle. And if you're here, it can't be good.
Don't you realize you're not just minding the door? You work for that crooked bastard, your hands get dirty too.
It's not so bad.
Not so bad? Are you fucking blind, Tim? He's a murderer.
So you're telling me you agree with everything Crane does? A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office, but he's there. We need you, but we need him too. What we don't need is a war. Hey, Sheriff, hold up. I gotta go in with you. Can't you just wait up, Sheriff? Thanks.
Man, some kind of fucking joke to you. What did I tell you, eh? Stop laughing at me.
Oh, yeah?
Go ahead. You got a job to do.
Sheriff Wolf, sir.
Thank you, Tim. I know the sheriff isn't the accommodating sort, but you handled it. You did well. You can go now.
Thank you, sir.
You see, everyone in Fabletown has a role to fill. You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it. Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
I've heard stories about you. In the old days, how you picked off those men one by one. Oh, how they screamed. The wolf is coming. And they would wait, hiding anywhere they could squeeze their pathetic, shivering corpses. Some would just drop to their knees where they stood, close their eyes, and wait for death. And you'd give it to them. I wish I could have seen it. Oh well.